children, welcome back. Today we are going to study chapter 5, the revolt of 1857. By 1856, most of the Indian subcontinent had been brought under the rule of the East India Company. However, various sections of people were badly affected by the oppressive policies of the British. So many revolts took place. Today we are going to discuss about revolt of 1857. The last emperor of the Mughal dynasty, also known as Bahadur Shah II, was given the role of leading the rebellion in Delhi. He was a beautiful poet. His poetry mostly dealt with love and mysticism. He even wrote of the pain and sorrow he suffered by the Britishers. The causes of the revolt of 1857. Political causes, social and religious causes, economic causes, military causes, and immediate causes. These were the causes of the revolt of 1857. Now we are going to study these in detail. Political causes. The political causes of the revolt may be traced to the British policy of expansion through the doctrine of lapse and direct annexation. A large number of Indian rulers and chiefs were dislodged, thus arousing fear in the minds of other ruling families who apprehended a similar fate. Rani Lakshmibai's adopted son was not permitted to sit on the throne of Jhansi. Satara, Nagpur and Jhansi were annexed under the doctrine of lapse. Jaipur, Sambalpur and Udaipur were also annexed. Other rulers feared that the annexation of their states was only a matter of time. The refusal to continue the pension of Nana Sahib, the adopted son of Bajirao II, created hostility among the ruling class. Moreover, the sentiments of the people were hurt when it was declared that the descendants of the Mughal Emperor Bahadur Shah II would not be allowed to live in the Red Fort. The annexation of Awadh by Lord Dalhousie on the pretext of maladministration left thousands of nobles, officials, retainers and soldiers jobless. This measure converted Awadh, a loyal state, into a hotbed by discontent and intrigue. Now, social and religious causes. A large section of the population was alarmed by the rapid spread of Western civilization in India. An act in 1850 changed the Hindu law of inheritance, enabling a Hindu who had converted into Christianity to inherit his ancestral properties. Besides, the missionaries were allowed to make conversions to Christianity all over India. The people were convinced that the government was planning to convert Indians to Christianity. The abolition of practices like sati and female infanticide and the legislation legalizing widow remarriage were threats to the established social structure. Even the introduction of the railways and telegraph was viewed with suspicion. Economic causes. In rural areas, peasants and zamindars resented the heavy taxes on land and the stringent methods of revenue collection followed by the company. Many among these groups were unable to meet the heavy revenue demands and repay their loans to money lenders, eventually losing the lands that they had held for generations. Large numbers of sepoys were drawn from the peasantry and had family ties in villages, so the grievances of the peasants also affected them. The economic exploitation by the British and the complete destruction of the traditional economic structure caused widespread resentment among all sections of the people. After the Industrial Revolution in England, there was an influx of British manufactured goods into India, which ruined industries, particularly the textile industry of India. Indian handicraft industries had to compete with cheap machine-made goods from Britain. India was transformed into a supplier of raw materials and a consumer of goods manufactured in Britain. All those people who previously depended on royal patronage for their livelihoods were rendered unemployed. So they bore a deep-seated grievance against the British. Military causes. Indian sepoys formed more than 87% of British troops in India. They were considered inferior to British soldiers. An Indian sepoy was paid less than a European sepoy of the same rank. Besides, an Indian sepoy could not rise to a rank higher than that of a subedar. The extension of the British Empire in India had adversely affected the service conditions of Indian sepoys. They were required to serve in areas far away from their homes. The Bengal army was recruited from high caste communities in Awadh. They were not prepared to cross the ocean, which was forbidden as per Hindu religious beliefs. They developed the suspicion that the government was trying to convert Indians to Christianity. After the annexation of Awadh, the Nawab's army was disbanded. These soldiers lost their means of livelihood. They became bitter enemies of the British. Now, immediate cause. The revolt of 1857 eventually broke out over the incident of greased cartridges. A rumor spread that the cartridges of the new Enfield rifles were greased with the fat of cows and pigs. Before loading these rifles, the sepoys had to bite off the paper on the cartridges. Both Hindu and Muslim sepoys refused to use them. Canning tried to make amends for the error and the offending cartridges were withdrawn. But by then the damage had been done. There was unrest in several places. In March 1857, Mangal Pandey, a sepoy in Barakpur, had refused to use the cartridge and attacked his senior officers. He was hanged to death on 8 April. On 9th April, 85 soldiers in Meerut refused to use the new rifle and were sentenced to 10 years imprisonment. The prominent leaders of 1857 revolt, the Rani of Jhansi, who sacrificed her life fighting in June 1858, Nana Saheb, the adopted son of the last Peshwa, Bajirao II, who led the mutiny at Kanpur and escaped to Nepal in the beginning of 1859, Kuwar Singh of Awadh, who had carved a base for himself in Ajamgarh and Ghazipur and breathed his last fighting in May 1858, Begum Hazrat Mahal, who also escaped to Nepal, Maulvi Ahmadullah, who carried on the revolt around the borders of Awadh and Rohilkhand till his death in June 1858, and Tatya Tope, uprooted from his base on the Jamuna at Kalpi, who reached Gwalior in June 1858, crossed the Narmada in October and was captured and put to death in 1859. All these leaders no doubt were affected by the policies of the British in the last 100 years and had genuine grievance against the British. Outbreak of revolt. Sepoy Rebel Inn. It is also known as Indian Rebellion of 1857. Sepoys rose up against officers. Many rebelling units marched to old capital of the Mughal Empire, Delhi, declared the last Mughal Empire their leader. Slaughtered thousands of British men, women and children. British paid back in kind, slaughtering unarmed Indians and rebels and burning entire villages. Results: British dominance reasserted a year after start of rebellion. Rebellions later used as rallying point for later Indian revolts against colonization. Reforms of India left to Indian social reformers chambers. Beginning and spread of the revolt. It started on May 10, 1857 in Meerut and spread to rest of the North India. You can see the major centers of revolt. Spread of revolt. Bahadur Shah, General Bakht Khan, Delhi. Nana Sahib defeated Hoogvliet in Kanpur. Begum Hazrat Mal declared her son Birgis Qadir as Nawab in Lucknow. Khan Bahadur from Bareilly. Kuwar Singh defeated William Taylor and Vincent Iyer in Bihar. Maulvi Ahmadullah from Faizabad. Rani Lakshmibai from Jhansi. Tatya Tope from Gwalior. Kadam Singh from Meerut. Devi Singh from Mathura. Liaqat Ali from Allahabad. Suppression of the revolt. British Army freed Delhi, the epicenter of the revolt. Bahadur Shah Zafar was tried and sent to Rangoon. His children were killed. The control of Delhi and imprisonment of Bahadur Shah Zafar broke the backbone of the mutiny. Lucknow was recaptured in 1858. Rani Lakshmibai was killed and Tatya Tope was captured and hanged to death. Now we will know the reasons for the failure of 1857 revolt. Administrative reasons. There was no planning among the rebels. It was an unorganized effort. The leadership was weak. There was no direction to the movement. Military reasons. British Army was superior in organization. British Army had unlimited supplies. The rebels had limited supplies and outdated ammunition. Ideological reasons. All sections did not participate, like princes and educated classes. There was no alternative to feudalism put forth by the rebels. The results of the revolt. The rule of East India Company ended with Queen Victoria's proclamation of November 1, 1858. She assumed the title of the Empress of India. A Secretary of State for India, Indian Affairs was appointed to look after the governance of India with the help of a council. He was called Viceroy. The policy of ruthless conquests and annexations of Indian territories was given up. The Indian princes were given the assurance that their states would not be annexed and were given the right to adoption. Full religious freedom was granted to the Indians. They were also given assurance that high posts would be given to them without any discrimination. Government of India Act 1858. It was enacted in the wake of the revolt of 1857. It abolished the East India Company and transferred all powers to the British Crown. It changed designation of Governor General of India to that of Viceroy of India. Lord Canning was the first Viceroy of India. Ended system of double government. New office, Secretary of State for India was created. Indian Council Act 1861. It's the first time Indians were associated with the administration and governance of country. Legislative councils set up at the center and provinces and presidencies, but with non-official members.